A few weeks ago, I made this animation where the musket was a very iconic musket. This ship was just a flintlock musket, but the different point is about its reloading method, because it removed the step of priming the pan, and it made this gun had a better firing rate. In real life, the original model is the M1784 flintlock musket, built by Prussians and Austrians in the 18th century. I believe you have noticed the reveal video of this classical gun in an Italian YouTube channel. Thank you for their hard work. We can also learn about the stories about this old gun, because I found that there may not be enough historical materials and the collection about the M1784 on Google. So their work is very valuable for those, including me, who want to learn about this gun. For me, after knowing this musket, there are two points that I noticed, and I think it was talking about. So into this video, let's talk about this topic: the tech of self-prime for the early generation guns and their flash guard. Self-priming for a musket, this is likely a very unique technology. When I first watched the firing video of the M1784 self-priming musket, I was very surprised by its firing range and the special reloading drill, and the gunner even needed not to prime the pan. So this typical point also gives this musket a better firing range. At that time, I had thought that the M1784 musket is likely more advanced than the contemporary musket for its great firing rate. This also might mean that this musket had an amazing and complex structure to realize the function of self-priming accordingly, because only the complex mechanism fits with the title of advanced, what I believed in my mind. But when learning the self-priming musket deeper, the mysterious phase gradually becomes clear and clear. The key is about this vent hole, or call it the touch hole. Typically, the vent hole of the self-priming musket is larger. We know that a common musket, not only the flintlock but also the matchlock, the ratio should be that the operator must pour the gunpowder from his paper cartridge on the pan, and the priming powder has to share with the main gunpowder. But when the vent hole is enlarged, the musketeer can pour all of the gunpowder of the paper cartridge into the barrel as the main powder. Then he can just shake and smoke the gun in order to set some powder to the pan from the breech easily, just like the operating pore size of the M1784 musket. Finally, it realizes the function of self-priming. In other words, building a self-priming musket is not really hard. The easiest way may be to take up a normal musket and drill and make the vent hole larger in order to build bigger way connecting the pan and the breech, so that the gunpowder can go out from the breech smoothly when the people smoke the gun. According to some speaking in the forum, there were some Native Americans who just used this way to modify their musket. In addition, there still is another factor that may also affect the musket if it can be a self-priming musket. This factor is about gunpowder. As we know that most of the muskets, especially almost all of the muzzle loaders, are always the black gunpowder firearms. So the granulation level of black powder is very important. The black powder has four kinds of different labels, from 1 knife to 4 knife. 1 knife is the coarsest, and 4 knife is the finest. The finer powder can pass out of smaller holes, so the same logic we also can put on in the vent hole of a musket. What if we use the finer powder poured into the barrel, and it may be easier that the powder can go out of the breech to the pan. But this point also brings out another problem. This is a safety problem. The finer powder also means that it can burn faster and will produce a higher pressure as a result. Meanwhile, most of the muskets were designed into a black powder gun, so it is possible that the pressure made from the finer powder could come close to the design limit for black powder guns. This kind of abuse may take a risk for the musket and the operator of the musket. So maybe this is the reason why the M78 full musket had a heavier and a thinner barrel. In addition, a self-priming musket like the M78 full musket needs a cartridge that carries 50% more powder than a standard cartridge. Besides this, the bigger torch hole may also mean that the condition of the ceiling will be worse. And also, as we can see in the videos, in with a common flintlock or matchlock musket, when firing it, there will be a big fireball and smoke will run out of the vent hole where it is very close to the musketeer. So what is with this common flintlock instead by the self-priming muskets with a larger vent hole? There would be a bigger fireball and more unburned gunpowder was spilled out against the gunner's face. So this may be why the M78 full musket needs the following gear on the pen. This is a flash guard. Actually, for a flintlock, this is a very useful safety equipment. It can protect the gunner. But we want to use the flash guard, we can use an external bolt in the freezing to fix it or fasten it to the pen directly. For a common flintlock, this is an optional gear. Comparatively, the self-priming musket has a larger vent hole, resulting in it can make a bigger fireball. So this may mean that this kind of musket needs this equipment very much. Maybe for the risks hiding behind the self-priming musket, this kind of musket might always be a kind of military gun, but not a civilian gun. But just like the opinion in the forum that I mentioned in my Vent to Prime video, the military was interested in firepower, not safety. So we may not see this kind of self-priming musket in the civilian gun area. Until now, we have seen a very common and also a very simple self-priming musket. But are there other self-priming muskets? I think the answer is yes. In the last year, we talked about some repeating muskets, like Kolchakov repeater, Lorenzoni repeater. They are indeed a repeating musket, and with a very complex mechanism. But meanwhile, they are also a kind of self-priming musket, and also may need another flash guard to protect the musketeer. Okay, the video is almost at the end, but before saying goodbye, I think I may make a pact. Because until now, we just talked about the tech of a self-priming on paper. So I think in the future, when I get the opportunity, I may use the real musket to test it, to feel the salt, the smoke, and the culture of a classical muscle loader. What if the dream can come true? I also will share it on this channel. Okay, this is today's video. Hope you enjoyed this video. Have a good day. See you next time. Bye.